So we are going to start the developing the cubes. So for the cubes, normally all the BI means you will be getting SSIS, SSRS and SSIS. That all three comes under the you will call it as Microsoft BI stack. So all the BI, if you want to develop, create an SSIS package, if you want to create SSRS package, if you want to create a SSIS package, a SSIS project, all the things you can create in the Visual Studio. So for open the Visual Studio, I'll just click on the Visual Studio. When I click this Visual Studio, it is nothing but the data tools. So if you go to the search button, because it is a 2012, right? So in the 2012, you will be having tools called data tools. When I type data tools, I'll getting SQL Server data tools. The SQL Server data tool is nothing but the Visual Studio. When I open the SQL Server data tools, I'll get this window. Now I will click a new project. When I click a new project, you got multiple things: analysis services, multidimensional, integration services, report server project, report server project, and another is analysis services, tabular project. So we are going to see about the tabular project later on. So integration services we have seen, report server we have seen. Now we are going to see with the analysis services, multidimensional. So analysis services, multidimensional is nothing but the cubes. Okay, it is nothing but the cubes. So now, same way as we, if you want to enter anything, so I'll name it as prac class. Prac class, some okay. I'll write just practice class as a cube name. Click OK. When I click, automatically, I got one project opened here. In this project, you got multiple stuff. You got the data source. You got the data source views, you got the cubes, you got dimensions, you got mining structures, you got roles, you got assemblies, and you got miscellaneous. So out of this, the important things are data source views, cubes and dimensions. These are the mostly thing, the most of the part you will be working on this, all the stuff. Okay, what is a data source and what is a data source view? Always for the SSIS cube, this is for always whenever you want to develop a SSIS cube, the one thing first, you need to get the data from the some. So let's say I want to develop the cube based on this factor. Most maximum of the time, whoever wants to develop the cube, the source will always be facts and dimensions. The source data will always be ROLAP. It will always be facts and dimensions data only, maximum number of times. Okay. So here, first thing, data source is nothing but from where you are getting that source. Okay, you will just create a connection for the database, that is a data source. Data source views is nothing but from which tables are you getting the data, because when you develop the queue, okay, you will mostly sales people wants other data, and let's say marketing people, they want separate thing, and there is one more team called finance, they want separate data. So basically you will be creating separate queue for each and everyone. Unlike the database, you can store everything in a single schema, right? But in the cubes, you will create separate queue for each and everyone, because the less the size of the cube, the less the time it takes for processing, because daily night you need to update the cube, you need to process the cube. If the cube is small, then it will be faster. And if you mix all the features in a single cube, and if you mess up anything, then it will be a problem. So the better thing is that for each and everyone, build separate cube. Okay. So this views, so let's say I work on the sales. So in the facts and dimension table, the sales is one table, and internet sales is all there, right? This facts tables may have only few dimension tables. Okay, that is the thing. So it is just nothing but the tables which you want to use for creating a cube, that all you will be getting in the data source views. After that, you will create a dimensions. This all are step by step, but normally basically what we are going to do, first you are going to create a data source, next data source views, next dimensions, and after that you are going to create a cube. Okay, and you are going to deploy an SSIS analysis services. We are going to see about them. Now here, data source, I'll right click on the data source, click a new data source. Data source is nothing but it is a database that you want to connect. Click next. So normally my database is this one, right? I think already I might have the connection, but leave it. Just this is my database, and I want to take the AdventureWorks data warehouse. This is the thing that I want to take. I took it. Okay. Now click connection. So it is a data warehouse. Click next. And one more thing, always here, whenever you want to use a connection, the better thing is that they will have some credentials. If you want to use the credentials, it is okay. But normally we use the user ID and password that we have assigned to that. So normally what I'm going to do is that I'll see my user ID and password. Go here, go into the logins, and this is my user ID. And I'll paste it here. See, remember, I came to back. So you select the data source, you have a next option here. So previously in other stuff, you will not have anything, but here you will have the next. When I click next, it will ask the username and password. So I'll give the username and I'll give my password here. Yeah, give me a minute. Yeah, I forgot to send the team viewer ID to Mavin. Yeah, he'll be joining the class. So we'll give the user ID and password to that. Now when I click next, automatically it will ask me, this is a connection, finish. So by default, what happens? I'll have my data source created here. This is a data source. Normally here in the SQL Server, basically what we do in this SSIS, the first thing you need to create, normally you have seen in the SSIS and SSRS, right? What you did in SSRS and SSIS, you always created a connection manager. So here the connection manager is nothing but the data source here in the SSIS. And you created some queries to pull the data, right? You created in the SSRS, you call it as data sets. Means you have written multiple queries, you have joined multiple tables, you write some queries. That queries, by using that queries, you pull the data. But here in the SSIS, you, instead of writing the query, you may write the queries or you can directly use this tables also. Okay. So I'll just right click the data source view. When I click the data source view, I'll go next. When I go next, now you can see already the data source which I have added, right? You can see the same data source here. And when I click next, whatever the tables I have in the data source, I'll get all the tables here and maximize this. So whatever the tables I got in the data source, I'll get all the tables. So first what I'm going to do, I'll just select one of the fact internet sales and click this arrow. So it will come here. I got it here. What I want, whatever the tables which are related to facts and dimension tables, fact internet sales. So now you can see here, when I go to the fact internet sales in the AdventureWorks data warehouse, I'll just right click here, or else I'll script the table, create table new query editor. Now you can see there are many relations to the facts and dimensions tables. See, these are the product key, right? At the bottom you can see there, I see the facts and dimension table, the column currency key is related to the dim currency table currency key. It is a foreign key constraint, right? So like the foreign key. This is a check constraint. Again, you got one more constraint with the foreign key. You got one more called foreign key. Means it is related to many tables. So if you want to get all the tables here, just select this. At the bottom, you can see add related tables. When I click this, whatever the tables are related to this facts internet sales, that all tables you can see at the bottom. Okay, which are interrelated, that all you can see at the bottom. And I'll click next. So I want all the tables, I'll click next. That's it. You got it. And when I click finish, now see, a window will open. This is the data source views. and you can see a window will open here, and you can see all the tables and the relation. See, this is a fact internet in a fact internet sales. This fact internet sales is joined to the DIM promotion, and when you click this line, then you can see on what column it has been joined, promotion key and promotion key. Okay, now you see DIM sales territory. When I click on this, now you can see sales territory key from the fact internet sales table and DIM sales territory table sales territory key. So it is a joining with. So now you can see from this table it is joined with three relations from the table. So what is that? When you click this, due date key, date key, that is a joining, and other is the see order, that is a due date key. Now it is order date key is joining with the date key, and here it is joining the ship date key, again joining with the date key. Okay, so in the SSRS cubes, in the cubes, they are in the dimensions also, there are multiple dimensions. Okay, the tall dimensions, about the dimensions we are going to see later on. Step by step we are going to see about the dimensions, what are the dimensions that we have on, what is the name for the dimension, we call it as role playing dimensions. Okay, like we got couple of names, that all the stuff we are going to see later on. Now just for understanding purpose I have given normal example. So this is a data source. So now here it has all the tables and it has a relation between them. So if you don't have a table, you can manually go here. Let's say I have deleted DIM promotion, I don't have the table name. At the previously I don't have, I deleted this. Now what I'll do, right click here, okay, add a remote tables, and what is the table name I added? I'll just add the related tables here. I'll just click cancel. I'll just do control Z. I think control Z will work, or here or not, I'm not sure. Yeah, it is not working. Just go add a remote tables, fact internet sales, add related table. Yeah, DIM promotion is a table name that we want to add. So I'll select the DIM promotion name and click OK. So now DIM promotion table is there. So instead of the DIM promotion table, one more thing you can do, you can write your own query. I'll right click here, new named query. See, instead of having the DIM promotion, I'll just remove this DIM promotion here, okay, for showing purpose. Now what I'll do, right click in the named query, here I'll get the DIM promotion query. Simply I'll get the DIM promotion table, DIM promotion as a query. I'll not get as a table, I'll get as a query. Close it. Now I'll select all the stuff, select star from done. Okay, that's it. I can name the table, I can name it as DIM promotion. Assume I'm getting from only one table, right? Instead of that, I can write multiple queries here. Instead of that, I can join a couple of tables and I can get the data. But here, assume that it is a big query where you will be joining multiple tables. Okay, assume that way. Click OK. Now what happens? A DIM promotion table will be there, but there will be no relation. Now what you can do? You can from this fact table and DIM promotion table, you can join the table. So here you will be having somewhere with the DIM promotion column, I think promotion key, and you will have the promotion key here also. So you got the promotion key. So what you can do, you can just click on the promotion key column and drop it on the promotion key of this table. That's it. Automatically a relation will be created. See, now when I see this, see DIM promotion table promotion key, okay, and fact internet sales promotion key, as a relation has been created. Now you can see the line. Okay, it is nothing but that kind of join. This is the other way you can do. And one more thing, basically whenever you develop this all the stuff, right, whenever you develop the tables, you got this fact internet sales DIM customer, right? Normally what we are going to do, you are going to change the name of this. So here at the top you can see DIM date. Okay, I'll select this, I'll go to the view properties, I'll go to the view and I'll select the properties window. When I select the properties window, now you can see it is a, see, DIM date. You got the name and the friendly name. Name is the original name of the table and DIM date is a friendly name. You can change whatever name you want. If I change this to date, then automatically you can see instead of DIM date name, you can see the date, but the original name will be as it is, DIM date. Now you can see DIM promotion. It is the thing which I have selected. See, instead of the name, it got the, because it is a query, right? You got the query. So I'll name it as promotion. Now click on the sales territory. I'll just remove the friendly name. I can give the friendly name. So in all the tables, DIM sales is the original name, but I'm naming a friendly name as sales territory, because in the dimension table, you don't keep DIM and fact. In the fact also, I'll just remove the fact internet sales. Sales reason. I'll select the dim currency. I'll remove the currency. This is the other way to do. Now you see fact internet sales. Remove the fact internet sales. Dim customer. I'll remove the dim customer. Dim product. I'll remove the dim product here. Done. So we have removed. So everything got the friendly name. Now instead of having fact and dimensions, we just got the table names. Now here there are many things to do. See, at the right side, left side here, you can see the promotion is a query, right? You are developed by using the query. So that's why you can see it here. It is in a different shape. Whereas other stuff, you can, it is of different type. Now you can see, when I click here, you can see all the columns that are there. You can also see the relationship between them. Okay. See, this currency is having relationship with the internet sales. See. Okay. See, internet sales table. Like this. And you can see the dim promotion. We created the we created relationship between the internet sales. I see internet sales like that. You can see, you can play around with them. When I click, you can see all the columns that are there in the table. You can also see, right click on this, and when I click the new, if you want to create a new relationship, you can create the relationship here itself. Instead of other, you can create a relationship here. Okay, there are many ways. Let's see. I'll just remove this promotion here. I'll delete the relationship. What happened? There will be no relationship for the promotion. Done. Now I can create a relationship here also. When I expand the promotion, actually I need to refresh it. Yes, save. And I again open this. Now I'll get this. Now you can see when I open the promotion. Actually it's showing the relationship. The relationship go actually. See, there is no relationship here. Now I can create a relationship. Right click, new relationship. Now this is the promotion code. And what is the source column I want? This is the promotion key. So what is the table other thing? Internet sales. And what is the, it is a promotion key. I'll take it and done. Now a relationship is created automatically. This is the other way you can create a relationship. And here, let's say from the source, this is my data. You got something called, where it is a customer. You got customer first name, middle name and last name. My scenario is that I want to have one more column called customer full name, which will have the first name and last name, which will have the last name comma first name. Okay, I will not want any middle name, just I want a last name comma first name. That will be the customer full name. So actually I don't have any column with the customer full name. So I can add one calculated column. Right click on this, add, see, and add name, new named calculation. When I click the named calculation, just I'll name it as full name. Here, see, in the expression, I can add all the column names. Whatever the column, it is a first name, right? Or it's the last name. Last name plus, it's just a whatever you do, right? In the SQL Server, you just use that the same thing here also. Plus, I'll give space. So here, I'll add the first name. You can see the columns here left side. Okay, first name, done. And you, if you want to give a description, you can give. When I click OK, see automatically a full name the symbol is changed here. When you normally see other column doesn't have any symbol, but this column has a symbol. So when I click this column, you can see that calculated field. Now one more thing, this is a table name, right? When I click the table and click the export data, explore data, you will get all the data that you will get the data that is there in the table. See, now I have given the full name, right? See, full name is a combination of first, last name and the first name. See, you got the full name column data. Okay, that is when you click the explore data, you will get, you can see what is, whatever the data you have there, you can see the data. Okay, now when you right click it, you can remove the tables, you can do the new relation. This is the friendly names. When I remove the friendly name, see, instead of showing, it directly shows the exactly table name. Now when I click this, when I click show friendly name, now it will show only the name that we had given here, friendly name. When I click this, you are given, right? This is the normal name, this is the friendly name. So that all the things you can get it. Now again I'll right click, see, select all. This is for all the tables. Now you can even find the table also. When I click the find table, see, whatever the tables you got in your this thing, you can see all the tables here. Okay, that's the thing. And you can if you want to arrange the table, you can arrange. by default the table is sometimes you, what might happen is that the tables might not be in the correct order. It may be like this. Okay, just right click on this, arrange the tables. Automatically it will be arranged. So this you can play around with the refresh. Done. No changes have done. Click OK. Sometimes the data or something you will be changing, right? When you do the refresh, automatically it will be reflected here at the left side. That's it. That's it with the each and everything. Now you see here, you got one zoom option. When I click zoom, and when I click 50%, now it will be reduced. But you can't see the columns because it's small size, right? When you increase it to something like 100%, 75% or something, then only you can see the columns. That all things. Now that is at the this level. When I click right click outside the tables. If I select any of the table and right click, see, you can do the new relationship, and this is the query, named query, because the promotion we are getting from using the query. See, when I see the properties, you can see by using query you got the data. So that's why when I click the promotion, you will have edit named query. But when I click date, you will not have this edit named query. Okay, because it is a table, right? So it is asking display table, but here it is asking a named query. And you can also delete from the, you can also delete this one from the view. You can, even you click the explore data, you will get the data. That's it. The only that is a explore data. Okay. So this is, then not only here, you can also do it here also. See, add or remove objects. When I click this, you can add the tables here. Instead of right clicking here and add tables, you can add the add by here also. And one more thing, you can see new diagram. When I click this, you can also create a new diagram based on the thing. I'm just closing that. I'll just have the old one. So it is nothing but the old diagram, right? If you want to create one more, just add a new one and you can add all the tables. And see, this is the thing, new named query. So this is nothing but the named query, right? You can also, instead of writing here named query, you can also click directly this one, then also you'll get that. And you can see a new relationship. Okay, if you want to create a relationship between them, you can create this way also. When I click, it will ask the sales table and destination table, you will give them, and on what columns you want to give, you will just give that column names. Okay, like this, instead of right clicking and doing here, you can also do by about that by using these tools also. Okay, this is a data source and this is a data source and this is a data source we use. Now the data source is nothing but in a SQL Server SSIS, from which database you want to pull, that is not that you will create a connection for that. The same as we did in the SSIS and SSRS, we created connection to the database, right? The same thing we do it here. The doing that stuff is nothing but the data source. And what is the data source we use now? Data source we use are nothing but just as I said, in the companies there will be some sales department, they want separate, they had separate requirements, and there will be something like marketing, they want separate, they had separate requirements for building the code. So better what you do, so all the tables are in a single database. So normally what you do, just create a table. So you will create a view where let's say this is, you create separate queue for each, you create a queue for sales, you create a queue for marketing, you create a queue for finance or anything, whatever department you have, you create separate cubes. So the finance may use some tables and the sales may use some tables and the marketing may use some tables, right? So whatever the tables you need for building the cube, okay. So let's say the finance, the sales people wants total sales, total tax amount paid, or total quantity sold. Okay, that all things they need. So where you will have that, the tables which are related to sales, that sales table will have the data regarding the sales. So whatever the table you have, you will get all the data here. You will get all the data into the cube. So just you'll create a data. So you can add multiple queues. Okay, I'll just right click here and I can add a remote table. If I want other view, just right click on this new data source view and I'll go here new. So previous adventure works next. So previously we did on the sales, right? Now instead of sales, we'll go with other thing, finance. When I click select the finance, I'll select add related tables, I'll get all the tables and click OK. Next, done. This is for the finance, see now. And automatically, see, the finance is also is a separate view. This finance is a separate view and it is nothing but it has a sales join, self reference key. Okay, if the relation is to the same table again, it is a self reference key. So this all the things you can work with them, but actually I don't need this. This is for the sales, right? So I am just deleting this. So it is nothing but grouping the tables. Whatever tables you need, you create, you'll take all the tables in one thing, and you'll call that as a view. That's it. Okay, done. I'm done. I'm deleted that. So now we add one cube and everything is okay. So this is with the data source and data source views. I'll stop this video and I'll continue other stuff with the next.